everyone! In this video, we are going to learn all about dual shaft BO motor, aka battery operated DC motor, how it works, how to interface it with prototyping boards like Evive and Arduino, and how to program it in PictoBlocks. Finally, we'll have a look at the wonders we can create using it. Let's begin. The dual shaft BO motor has a gearbox along with a DC motor in its casing to control its speed. Similar to the other motors, the DC motor also takes in energy from one end and converts into rotational energy from the other end by rotating the shaft. The shaft can thus be connected to some other machine and make it rotate. Now that we know how the DC motor works, let's have a look at how to interface it with Evive and see it in action. You can directly connect and control two DC motors at the same time with Evive, as it has two dedicated motor channels, M1 and M2. Let's connect the motor to the M1 motor channel. Attach the wheel on one of its shafts. Now switch Evive on, then from its menu, select Controls. Next, select Motors. Finally, navigate through to Motor Channel 1. You will observe two terms on Evive screen. PWM determines the speed of the motor, which can be controlled using the potentiometer knob. DIR stands for direction. DIR1 represents rotation in one direction and DIR2 represents the other direction. We can change the direction using Evive's slide switch. Now let's program our DC motor with PictoBlocks. It is a graphical programming software based on Scratch blocks. You can download it from the link given in the description box below. Before doing anything else, connect Evive to your computer using a USB cable. Next, open PictoBlocks. Then, click on the board button and select Evive from the drop-down. Now from the dialog box that appears, choose the appropriate serial port. Before writing the script, make sure that the firmware is uploaded. If not, upload it using the upload firmware button. Here's the logic of our script. On pressing the up arrow key of the keyboard, the motor should rotate in one direction with 100% speed. Add an if-else arm to check whether the up arrow key is pressed or not. If the down arrow key is pressed, the motor should go in the other direction with 100% speed. However, if none of the keys is pressed, the motor should be at rest. Use the free motor block to stop the motor from running. To run the script continuously, we'll use the forever block. Place the wind flagged click head block above the forever block. It will ensure that the script runs when the green flag is clicked. Now check whether the motor is running perfectly fine or not by running the script. Since everything is perfectly fine, let's write a script to run the DC motor without having Evive connected to the computer. For that, we'll have to work in the upload mode. We are going to make a script to run the motor according to the values entered using the potentiometer 1. We are going to use an if-else block to check whether the slide switch 1 is in the up state or not. If it is up, then the motor should rotate in the clockwise direction with a speed obtained from the potentiometer 1 reading. Add another if-else below the else arm of the first if-else block to check whether the slide switch 1 is in the down state or not. If yes, then the motor should rotate in the counterclockwise direction with the speed obtained from the potentiometer reading. However, if the slide switch is in the center, the motor should stop rotating. Thus, drag and drop a free motor block below the else arm. Use a forever block to run the code continuously. Place the when Evive starts up head block to execute the program. Finally, upload the code using the upload button. Now that you know how to work with a dual shaft BO motor, there are a number of projects you can make using it, like a DIY swing fan, a four-wheel drive robot, a turntable, and much more. That's it for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such educational content, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye-bye!